Ian and Roisin, take a look at this.
Someone being given the bill. Getting a bit of a shock. Oh, it's him. And him saying I didn't have the starter and didn't drink much.
It's David Cameron getting a massive bill when he went to Europe for not turning his date of roaming off.
1.7 billion, it's a lot, isn't it? No, he got a shock, cos, although we know the Prime Minister's absolutely on top of all the detail, no-one had told him that he was due to get a £1.7 billion bill, so he had a bit of a fit. And he said, I'm not going to pay it.
You're bang on. Of course, it is the £1.7 billion. It's landed on David Cameron's desk. Why exactly was it sent to us?
It came about because there's an annual recalibration, I think they call it. Mm. But they've done it over 11 years. And suddenly the EU says, can you give us £1.7 billion? Mm. And they were rather shocked.
It feels a little bit like the EU are doing that thing when you go out with someone and they want you to dump them. So they just start behaving really badly. For things that are going to annoy you. It's, you know, if you've ever been out with a boyfriend, they're sort of like, oh, I want a threesome and I want 1.7 billion by the 1st of December. So that's what it feels like.
Yeah, I know that so well.
What did he actually say, Cameron, about not paying?
He said, if anyone thinks I'm going to pay this now, he added the now, they've got another thing coming.
Yeah.
Because obviously he'll pay it later. And he got suspicious because Britain has to pay more, but funnily enough, Germany and France have to pay less. I wonder how that came up. Then they said it was because Britain's doing so well, but Greece also had to pay more. I'm not sure about this rationale.
And it's quite a short time span. You know, we should be able to pay off a little bit a month. You know, if you get a massive bill and they sort of go, it's their fault if they sort of, if they haven't charged us enough over 11 years.
Yes, it's Mrs. of... Merkel as Wonga.
But it's GDP, isn't it? It's the thing, and the one of the complaints is that they've been measuring our GDP in a way that includes drugs and prostitution.
Yeah.
Which is, if you think, that is a reasonable way of measuring how an economy is doing.
Yeah.
Is it?
Because, well, it is, yeah. Because obviously, if a country, if there's more disposable income, yep, then they'll spend more on drugs and prostitutes.
Well, for a lot of people, Andy, those are necessities.
Well, that's why Italy's GDP, yeah, is so low, mm, because once you factor out Berlusconi, yeah, there's...